हरी शरणम्। अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। सहना भवतु सहनो भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधितमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। माय डियर स्पिरिचुअल फ्रेंड्स, फेलो सीकर्स, the path of spiritual perfection. Today we are going to discuss about an important topic from Ishavasya Upanishad. In the third sloka of Ishavasya Upanishad we find Asurya Namate Loka अंधेन तमसा व्रताः तांस्ते प्रेत्याभिगच्छन्ति एके चात्महनो जनाः। आत्महनो जनाः, हियर इट इज पर्टिनेंट टू नोट द वर्ड हना हियर मीन्स टू डिस्ट्रॉय और किल एंड इट रेफर्स टू दोज हु किल दिस आत्मन, that is those who commit suicide. What is committing suicide after all? It means that we ourselves by our own self destroy the Atman. In the waking consciousness the Atman is identified with the body. In the dream stage the Atman is identified with the mind, while in deep sleep states, we are not aware of what is to be identified with what, or there seems to be nothing at all. Hence, during all the three states, we do not understand what this Atman is, nor its nature. To engage ourselves in action without realizing what this Atman is, or understanding its nature, is to act contrary to its nature. This is referred here to be killing Atman, or in other words, doing actions which are not good for us, which can't bring us the right fruits. With this meaning only, this word is used here as hanaha, atma hanaha, killing of the Atman, not understanding our own self and thereby destroying the self by executing irrelevant and wrong action in a very wrong manner is suicide. The reason for rebirth or for getting another body is precisely due to the wrong identification of Atman with the body. But for this, there won't arise in us desire, anger, attraction and repulsion, all these dualities. So the first mistake we commit is the wrong understanding that the Atman is the body. Next, we commit the mistake of saying that the objects are outside us. Then we connect ourselves with them and say, I am connected to the objects and I must obtain them or I must avoid them. What is the net result? We seek connection with the outside world. Now we land in this mess of wrong knowledge and are cut up. This mental condition ends in rebirth, bringing in its wake desire, anger, lust, hatred, etc., etc. This state is designated as tamas or darkness in Upanishads. Such darkness prevails in the world of demons. In other words, it is a world filled with the demonic wealth, a veritable kingdom of the demons, wherein there is no light. There are two types of darkness. One is physical, caused by the elements of nature known as adhivautik, and the other is adhyatmik, that is relating to one's self. So, to be without God consciousness is darkness. In Srimad Bhagavad Gita, we find Yani sa sarvabhutanam tasyam yagarti sanjami yasyam jagrati bhutani shanisa pashyato munihi. To the gyanis, to whom the light of wisdom shines, this darkness appears to be non-existent, as it is all light for them. But what we see with the light of the physical sun only, to the gyanis, that is darkness, which means they do not see the objects of this world as we see them. They see only the reality behind the objects. Hence, what is darkness for us is light for them. The sages live in the Atman, whereas that life in the Atman is night for us. It is quite different for us. Not only are we ignorant of the spirit, the supreme reality, but also we are caught up in the veil that covers it. This avarana shakti is something in addition to darkness, the ignorance which causes rebirth. It's not that merely ignorance which causes darkness, it further goes beyond even this condition and sees that which is not there. This further blunder is vikshepa, which means perverted view, or in other words, we are confused in seeing that which is untrue and in remaining blind to what is true. First, the veiling power makes fool of us, and next, the vikshepa shakti puts before us an illusion. Thus, in one breath, we commit two wrongs. First, we forget sat as the real, and next, we catch hold of asat or the unreal. This is precisely the nature of the world experience. We do not let go of the world, and yet we wish to pull out of the world to save ourselves. Hence, so long as the mind is supported by the sense organs, only the objective world alone appears to be real. The Atman cannot rest peacefully in any limited time or space, and this is an unalterable fact and a psychological truth. When the mind loves an object, it considers it as a part of the self. As a result, when the object is lost, there is a feeling of having lost a part of one's very self. To thus live in a world of wrong identification is to live in the world of objects or the Asurya Loka. How can objects be identified with the Atman? This can never be. This is why we are in the world of darkness. All knowledge which you have acquired by our intellect and rational thinking is also a kind of illusion. For intelligence exists even in foolish people. Intelligence and knowledge are not the same thing. Intelligence is acted upon by the veiling power. Understanding and knowledge by perversion in assessing the information brought in by the senses. Both these affect our actions. Not only senses cover the truth behind the objects, but also veil the understanding, thereby giving rise to wrong actions. This constitutes the world of darkness. One who forgets the Atman is the one who commits suicide. Not he who hangs himself with a rope. Forgetting the Atman is killing the Atman. And this is referred here in this mantra. Further, Kathopanishad says, living in the midst of ignorance and considering themselves intelligent, the non-discriminating persons suffer in the cycle of birth and death. To save one's self from the kind of birth and death cycle, we should purify the mind, and by doing karma as an offering to the Lord, we can attain the summum bonum of life. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.